Hey everyone, welcome to my channel Coding Cure. Today I will discuss one of the microservices concept called API Gateway. In this picture you can see that the request is coming to this API Gateway and the API Gateway is communicate with Eureka service registry. What is mean by API Gateway? So API Gateway is nothing but it's a component which sits between client and our services, multiple services. For example, so let's say this is my API gateway, okay? This is API gateway. So when the request will come, the request will come from where? The request will come from different client, right? The client is nothing but, let's say this is my one of the client. So this is mobile application and this is web application, and let's say this is postman. Okay, this is postman. So the request is coming from different client, and the API gateway will catch the request and forward the request to the different service. Suppose this is my one of the service, this is my one of the service, this is my one of the service. So it sits between client and services. Okay, what's the benefit if you are using this API gateway? So first benefit is, we can say it's a centralized request routing. What is centralized request routing? So before the API gateway, when I'm sending the request, I'm sending the request to this particular server, okay, this one or these services. So I'm just give the IP address as well as the port number, and I'll hit the services. Okay, let's say I have 100 of services, then I have to remember all the service information, right? Like URL and the port number, all these things I need to remember. So, and if you send the request, there is no common entry point here. The request can come to these services, the request can come to these services, and this request is coming from client. Okay, so there is no common entry point. So when we'll implement our API gateway, it's a centralized request routing. So the request will come to this API gateway first, then only the API gateway will routing the request to the particular service. Okay, this is one of the benefits we can get by using API gateway. Then the second benefit we'll get, like load balancing. I have already discussed in my previous video how the load balancing is work. Suppose this is my services, okay? Suppose these services have three instances, okay? This is one instance, and this is one instance, and this is one more instance. This is instance one, this is two, and this is three. Then when I'll send the request from here, the first the request will go to the API gateway. Then API gateway will send the request to this service, but which of the service it will send the request? So it will have to load balancing. Based on the load balancing, it will send the request to the particular services. This is one of the features we are getting by using API gateway. Then third is authentication. Okay, authentication. First I'll send the request to the API gateway, then API gateway will sense the or filter the request. First it will check for validation whether it's authenticated or not, then only it will send the request to the particular service. Okay, we are centralized the authentication request also. Then API integration. What is the mean by API integration? API integration is nothing but it will combine the data from different services. Like suppose this is one of the services, let's say user service, okay, and this is one more services called order detail services. Order details service. Okay, so here two services is there, one is user service and one is order detail service. So when I'll send the request to this API gateway, suppose this is an API gateway, I send the request to here. Now the API gateway, suppose call this user services and order detail services. So it will get the data from user services and order detail services. Then he can combine these two response and sends back to the client. This is one of the helps we can get by using the API gateway. Then next is monitoring and analytics. Analytics, like suppose I just wanted to metrics, like collect metrics like request, how many request comes, the count of request, okay, how many request comes, or what's the response time, error rates, all these things I can also monitoring by using API gateway. So this is the feature we can get by using the API gateway. First it's centralized request routing, then load balancing, then authentication, and then API integration, then monitoring. Now the question is, how we'll implement the API gateway? Okay, let's go to coding part. Here I have already created four services. One is fun service, one is fun service two. Like I have created two instances of my fun service, then service registry, and then user service. Let's start this service registry. Okay, then I can start the fun services, then user services. Okay, now I'll create one project, okay, which I can implement the API gateway. Spring Boot starter project, then API gateway. I can here change like API gateway. Then next, here I'll add dependency like cloud gateway. Okay, cloud something gateway is there. Okay, there is two gateway is there. One is normal gateway and one is reactive gateway. So we'll use Spring Cloud gateway. Okay, then we need to add this dependency, reactive gateway. Okay, then third thing is Spring Boot web, Spring web. Then next is we can add the dependency for Eureka client, Eureka discovery client. Okay, then next, this is finished. Here API gateway created. Now I just change the port number. So instead of properties file, I'll create one YAML file here also, right? File application dot YAML. So here first I can mention the application name. Spring dot application name is this is API gateway, then server dot port, right? So I can mention this one first is server port. Okay, this one. So suppose it is running on 8080. Okay, now I'll add for Eureka client, right? So service URL Spring Cloud service registry Eureka client service URL, yes, this one. Then default churn with I'll mention the where the Eureka is running. Okay, the Eureka is running on localhost 8761. Okay, I'll just copy this path, paste it. Okay, now why it is giving error? It is Eureka client. Okay, fine. Then after adding this property, I have to enable the Eureka client, right? In API gateway, I'll go here. I can enable discovery client. Now, when I'll send the request to this API gateway, I'll routing the request to that particular services. Okay, so for example, I'll send the request to the fund services. Instead of sending the request to the fund service directly, I'll access this fund service through the API gateway. Then how I'll configure the routing logic here to call this or to routing this request to this fund services. Here one properties is there like routes, Spring Cloud Gateway, Spring Cloud Gateway routes ID equal to, suppose I can mention fund service. This one I can give any name. Okay, this ID is a unique ID, and I'll call to the fund services. That's why I mention here ID is fund services. Okay, then I'll mention the URI. Here URI I need to mention, like I'll use the load balancing here. Okay, LB is nothing but load balancer colon double slash. Then if I'll go to here in Eureka, I just here the fund service running on this one and the user service running on this port number. Here I'll mention load balancing colon instead of mentioning the IP address, we can mention only the application name here. Okay, application name, that's it. Then I'll use predicate. Yeah, now in the predicates I need to mention the URL name. Suppose I'll send the request and the request will go to the fund services. Okay, so in the fund services, if you will go to the controller class, here I just mention slash fund. This is request mapping. Then after that slash fund, there are so many endpoint is there. So I can mention like, if the request come to this slash fund, then I'll call this API. So in predicate section, I need to mention hyphen path equal to, I can mention fund slash star star. So when we'll send the request to here fund services, okay, first it will go here like lb colon fund services. This is load balancer. It will go to the service register here based on the application name. Okay, it will send the request to either any of the instances. Like now in fund services only one instance is there. Suppose I'll create one more instance, then it will either call to this service or this services. Okay, then which API will call? Suppose I'll call this API, this create fund, okay, or get fund by ID. Then it will check the application YAML like slash fund. This is the first mapping, slash fund, then star star. I am allowing all these endpoints here, but why it's giving error? Path slash fund slash star star. Okay, yeah, there is some indentation problem, that's why it's giving error. Now I'll run this API gateway. See here, application Spring MB is not found on class path, which is incompatible with Spring Cloud Gateway. Okay, when we'll use Spring Cloud Gateway, we have to use like either application is reactive, or we can add the dependency for Spring Boot Starter Web Flux. Okay, so this is not supported with normal Spring Web MVC. It is supported for reactive application. So here I can mention the web application type. So type is, okay, web application. Yeah, web application type. So I can mention this is reactive. Okay, either we can mention in properties file reactive, or we can add the Spring Boot Starter Web Flux. But why it's giving error? Yeah, due to some indentation problem. So here, yeah, I can, yeah, it's fine now. Let's run the application. Now I just run this application. Yeah, now why it's giving error? Properties under gateway predicates to use value path. Okay, maybe this path is not colon, it's equal. Okay, yeah, now just run this one more time. Yeah, now the API gateway has started on 8080. Now I'll send the request. Suppose this is in this postman, this is fund services. So here I have one API called get fund API, and I'm passing 9091. If I'll send the request, I'm getting the data, but I'll send the request to this particular services. I'll create here, like I can duplicate this API instead of get fund throw API gateway. So now here I'll send the request to the API gateway. My API gateway is running on 8080. Now I'm not sending the request to the fund services. Instead of, I'm sending the request to the 8080. If you'll check here in Swagger, just refresh it. Yeah, now API gateway also running. Now I'll send the request to here, this localhost 8080 fund get fund by ID. This one is something like, I'll send the request to the API gateway. It's not the particular service. So send it. Yeah, now I got the response. The request is coming this API gateway. This API gateway will connect it to the service registry and find the service name. Okay, based on the service name, he is sending the request. Suppose I'll run this one also, this one service. Yeah, now started. I'll go to the service registry. Here I just refresh it. Now the fun service has two instances. Okay, now if I'll send the request also, I can get the response. See, so this is how API Gateway is working. Thanks for watching my video. In the next lecture, I'll come with one more microservice topic. Okay, thank you once again.